Hey guys, in the previous video I have talked about the conditional breakpoint. You can find the link to that video in the description below. In this video, I'm going to talk about the debugger actions. Let's go back to the inventory table that we have created in the previous video. We have two rows here. Now let's update one of the rows using a background script. Let's change the scope. Let's retrieve the list and let's get the next one and set the item category of the first row from computers to machine and let's update it. That should trigger the breakpoint. We got the debugging notification and we are presented with the breakpoint, which is paused at line number 4. You have seen that in the previous video. Once we press that, if there are no breakpoints, the execution will be completed. However, if there is another breakpoint, the execution will be paused at that particular line. Now let's go back to the background scripts and update it again. And if we press the resume execution over here, it takes us to line number 12. Now if we press that again, since there are no breakpoints, the execution will be finished. Let's look at the first icon over here, which is pause debugging. If we press this, you can see that the debugger is turned off, and even if we update the table, it will not trigger the breakpoint even though the debugger window is still open. You can turn it back, and if you update the table again, it triggers a breakpoint and it works as usual. Now let's look at the third icon, the step over. If we go back to the background scripts and execute the script, it will update the first row and which will trigger a breakpoint. If we press resume, it takes us to line number 12, but if we press step over, it takes us to the next line. And if we press it again, it takes us to for loop, which will execute 5 times. So that's 2. And once that is finished, we reach line number 12. And if we press resume here, it finishes the execution because we don't have any more breakpoints left. Let's look at the next debugger action, the step into. This allows us to debug other scripts which doesn't have breakpoints set inside them. For example, the inventory prices. You can see that we have 2 breakpoints only in this business rule. Let's go to the inventory table and update a row. The breakpoint is triggered. And let's step over to the line 6. And if we press step into, it takes us to the inventory prices first line. If we press step over, it takes us to line 6 again, and if we press step into again, it takes us to the initialize method. And if we press step over, it takes us back again, and press step into again to get into the get latest method. If we press step over, it moves to the next line and then back to the line 6. If we press resume, it takes us to line 12, and then if we press it again, the execution will be finished. Let's look at the last debugger action, the step out. We have 2 breakpoints, one in the business rule and the other in inventory prices at line 7. Let's go to the inventory table and update a row, which will trigger a breakpoint. You can see that it stopped at line 4, and if we press resume, it goes to line 7 in the scripting loop. But this is at line number 6 in the original business rule. If we have to go back again, we can press step out, which will take us to line 6 from where the script include was executed. From here, you can step over into the rest of the script. So that is how you can use the step out function. to move up the call stacks. So that's about the debugger actions. In the next video, we'll talk about call stacks, transaction details, and the variable sections that we have on the right side. Meanwhile, if you have any queries, please reach out to community.servicenow.com.